Robert B. Sherman and Richard M. Sherman reminisce about their work on The Jungle Book, January 5th, 1990.
One very fortunate day, Walt Disney called us in and said he'd like us to take a crack at writing some songs for The Jungle Book. We knew that it was being written by a good friend of ours, Terry Gilkison.
And we were sort of surprised because we didn't know why we were being asked at all. He was doing a whole score for it, and what we learned was that the original writers were so honest and sincere and straight ahead with the Kipling material that they had lost all that sense of fun and Disney magic. What he said the first time in the first meeting was, "Have you read Jungle Book?" We said, "Well, no, not for a long, long time. I think I remember seeing an old Korda movie with Sabu in it," and he says, "Yeah, that's right. Nice, mysterious, heavy stuff. That's not what we want to do."
He gave us things to think about, like don't be too heavy, don't be like the original book, give it a lightness, give it a Disney quality. And that's what we believed was what we had to work with. So we did. One of my favorite songs is the one of the elephants, Colonel Haffey's March.
One of the things I think was the idea of getting humor into a march, and one of the ways of doing that was actually do the drill as if they were real soldiers. So we had the hop, two, three, four, keep it hop, two, three, four. And all those martial commands were all part of it. But then on top of that, they'd comment on what they were doing. And of course, the comments, the lyrical comments, were all about what an aimless, pointless, silly thing they do, but they have a good time doing. And the very first meeting we had, I remember we were discussing the kidnap sequence. Now, that's what's funny about kidnapping, you know, where do you get light out of that? The King of the Apes, a rather grim character, had taken Mowgli, and he wanted to get the secret of fire from him. Well, that's kind of heavy stuff. And we wanted to lighten it up, so I remember we kicked around the idea of doing a Dixieland tune. We had originally recorded I Want to Be Like You with the vocal tracks clean, except for the fact that Louis Prima came in and laid his track on, and Sam Butera did the answers, particularly on the scat part. And then finally we got Phil Harrison into the studio. He was listening, I remember, to the scat and the answers. And
we sent him
the
tape.
That's right, yeah. That's right. He had that, and then also in the booth. So he was familiar with this. But we had something like Louis Prima would go Scooby-Dooby-Doo, and then Sam Butera did Scooby-Dooby-Doo, and then the other one said Hobba-Dubba-Dye, Hobba-Dubba-Dye. It was like answer, answer. And Phil Harris said, you know, I wouldn't say those same things. It wouldn't be right for me. And we had fixed in our minds already it was going to be aping. One would say it and the other would ape it. And he said, it'd be much more natural if I did my own thing. So that's why you had Scooby-Dooby-Doo, Reba-Naza, Hobba-Dabba-Doy, Reba-Rody. I mean, he had different words and different sounds that were strictly his own. And it came out very impromptu. Now, the next time around, they did another scat chorus. And we said, Phil, this time don't do sounds. How about trying some answers to what he was saying? And there was one point where Louis Prima growled. He went, rah, rah. And Phil Harris, in the mirror, he said, get mad, baby. And everybody in the booth was busting up because it's so typical of Phil Harris and very funny. And that's the kind of thing. He brought his own persona into it. And it
was an invaluable contribution, really was. And Louis Prima and his band and witnesses were so excited that the animators came down and photographed the musicians playing, so they could use their movements for the other apes in the picture.
So this spontaneous little 3 minutes of silliness actually took about 6 months or 8 months to put together, and we had fun with the song. There was one verse we did that was for the picture, but unfortunately got cut out. I love this one. I'll ape your mannerisms, we'll be a set of twins. No one will show where man cub ends and orangutan begins. And when I eat bananas, I won't peel them with my feet. Cause I'll become a man cub and get some etiquette. Say, ooh, 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 I wanna be like you, ooh, ooh, I wanna walk like you.
There was one song that was Ka, the snake, and we had to have a song for him. Well, quite a while back, we had written a song for the Around the World sequence in Mary Poppins, which was never shot, called The Land of Sand. And we said, that's the tune we ought to use.
And we happened to have a title. We wanted to use. We wanted to play on the snake's problem. He has a hissy problem because every time he says S's, they come out
sibilant.
And so we wanted to play on that. So we had Trust in Me, Just in Me. But we never could quite get the right melody, the right mysterious melody, till we recalled this old tune.
The original demo recording for The Land of Sand, as presented to Walt Disney for Mary Poppins.
In the land of sand, nothing is what it seems. Visions may be real, and the real things may be dreams. Secrets of all the ages hide in these sands of time, here where the story of man began. Oh, be wise and beware, what you see may not be there. Dreams can sleep.